Hi guys. Happy Thursday. I hope you guys had an amazing one. I'm not sure what time it's gonna be when I upload this, but hi. So I just wanted to start off this video by just thanking you guys from the bottom of my heart, each and every single one of you, friends and family, for donating to me, you know, donating to this this path and journey that the Lord has called me on, and just for supporting me financially, spiritually. Just wow, I'm so overwhelmed and genuinely speechless. Like I've never experienced this much generosity before, and it's really mind-blowing to see and just experience firsthand, you know? Yeah, honestly, every single donation and just, you know, direct message, email, text, like saying that, like, you guys are praying for me and supporting me, it truly means so much to me. Like, I really can't express how much I just love and appreciate it. thank you. So I wanted to make this video just to share with you guys why I'm even going on this trip, because I've never really talked about it to this extent before. So let's, you know, go back to sophomore year. Ages ago, I know. So a week before sophomore year, I became a Christian, and I was really new, and I barely knew anything. But I was really bold in my faith, I would say, and a lot of people would come up to me and just, you know, ask me questions, because it was really evident that I was not the same person I was before freshman year, you know? Like, freshman year, honestly, every other word out of my mouth was a swear word, and, you know, I would be all up on that drama and gossip. And sophomore year, I just stopped it, you know, like abruptly. But very specifically, these two guys that I knew and I had class with, what was it, science class or something, I'm honestly not sure. Yeah, they came up to me and they asked me a lot of questions, and obviously I didn't know a lot of the answers to those questions, because I was like, you know, I was a newborn baby. And one question they asked me was, what are you gonna do? You know, like, what are you gonna do after high school? Are you gonna be a nun? And and I actually told them that I had absolutely no plans. Like, I was, at that time, I was waiting for the Lord to tell me what to do with my life, because I had no plans and desires of my own anymore. And I was pretty, you know, I was kind of left there, you know, not knowing what I was gonna do. And I told them that, and the look on their faces was just like, is she crazy? Like, she's gonna wait for God to tell her what to do? And yeah, I went home that day, you know, cried, like, that is pretty crazy. Like, I kind of got a glimpse of, like, the extent of how, you know, risky that is. And, you know, the Christian life is uncomfortable, and the path that the Lord has called me to is not traditional. Like, I'm not going, you know, immediately to some college on the mainland like everyone else I know. And yeah, He calls us and He sets us apart. And I'm not sure the exact instance, but I do know that He just planted a seed and would just like constantly water it, with, you know, the seed being the idea of missions. And I know that was the Lord, because I would have never ever dreamed or thought about being missionary. And so here I am. He told me, you know, one day I just looked up long-term mission trips, and the World Race was actually the second one to pop up. The first one was YWAM, and I prayed about it, and it was just not the one that the Lord had called me on. And so, someone's calling me right now. But yeah, I applied, and ever since I've just seen the Lord work so heavily in me. And I know that's because He's preparing me, He's preparing my heart for this thing that He has called and made me for, you know? And it's just, it's really, it's overwhelming, but it's comforting and just gives me a sense of peace, but also just, I'm growing so much. And just like how my squad mentor said, how we grow like in our bodies, you know, growing pains because we're getting bigger. That's like the same spiritually. That's exactly what I'm going through. Like, growing hurts, you know, for me at least. And so that's where I'm at right now. And I just, I've seen the Lord so extravagantly and just so obviously worked in, oh my gosh, wait, no, my dog is so cute right now, wait, let me show you. Why are you so cute? Can you tell me why? Maybe be. And just with him revealing to me his character, I completely believe that I will reach this fundraising goal that I've set like only a few days ago. You ready for it? Okay. So I have, give me a second. I got me 44 people. 44. This is so, look, 18 right there. Oh my gosh, it's crazy. Okay. So my initial goal was to have all the 100 balloons that I by myself with the help of my, you know, Nico, little baby Nico, blown up inside myself. I have 44 left, and I completely believe that all of these balloons will be popped by the end of my birthday day, which is tomorrow. I'm so excited. Not ready to be an adult though. Can I just be 18 but not grow up? Is that an option? But yeah, so these 44 balloons, if you want to help me achieve this, this crazy goal, there will be the link to donate in the description, whatever thing below, and you just press on it, and there will be a bar there that says on the right hand side, it will say donate, and you just press that, and every single balloon is $18. Thank you. Okay. So yeah, I have 44 more balloons, and I just want to say thank you to everyone who's already given out of just the love and generosity of their heart to support me in this crazy awesome journey that the Lord has called me to. And yeah, I'll keep you guys on an update. I'm sorry I have not been posting those cute baby pictures as of late, just because I went camping with my family this weekend. It was really fun. I'll actually just post a picture right now just to show you guys how fun it was. So yeah, I love every single one of you guys, and bye. I'm gonna turn, not 81. Oh wait, is this? No, this is 18.